Welcome everyone, I'm Iconic Gamer 82. This is part 18 of my walkthrough for BioShock 2 with all collectibles. I'd like to thank you for watching and we shall begin. We're now at Fontaine Futuristics. So let's have a scout about. We've got all the weapons.
This is it, Chief. End of the line. If I'm right, Eleanor's mama's using Adam to force all Rapture's minds and memories into the poor girl. Lamb reckons it'll make that child a saint. Now, Eleanor's in a deep, dark place beneath Fontaine headquarters, and to keep you alive, we need to sneak in and find her.
So, our first collectible, let's have a quick little recap. What have we got left to do? Sorry, bugger, lead head, Houdini we've got to do, spiders are done, big daddies are done, big sisters we've got to do, security and brute are done. So at the minute we've got big sister and Houdini. I'm sure we're going to have alphas to do as well. So here's our first collectible.
This facility belongs to the city now, to Ryan Industries, at least until the rioting subsides. While it is unfortunate that such measures had to be taken, I must admit, it is gratifying to see this building condemned. Fontaine is gone, Lamb is gone, I am alone.
So that's the first collectible. Where's she then? We've got plenty of spear ammo. I must really get the most out of your unlocked damage bonus with damage research. This is that one again.
October 9th, 1967. Hello. My name is Gilbert Alexander. And by the time you hear this, I will be clinically insane. I am recording these diaries in advance as a last-ditch effort to assist anyone I might threaten in dealing with me. My next message awaits you beyond the security checkpoint. The bioscan will ensure that you're sane enough to need it.
So let's head outside.
Gil Alexander. As I recall, he was involved in Big Daddy development from the beginning. Likely had something to do with you and Eleanor, son.
Yeah, there might be some more little Adam slugs. Have a little scout about. Oh look, there's one.
Thank you.
An auto hack dart, lovely. You're fired. No, I don't want cigarettes. No. He's got an arping.
The Great. Oh, hell, that has to be Gil Alexander, same man who left that message we're following. He sounds mad as a March hare now.
Definitely does. Well, that ain't gonna stop us. Try and find some help. Right. Let's go up here and have a look. See what we can find. Bandages. Always handy. I'll check out your
bioscan. Identifying clearance level. Identified clinical trial subject. Classification. Protector. Designation. Delta. Status. Deceased. Error. Updated status. Please stand by.
Yeah. vulnerable to armored vehicles. Alpha.
Hello again. I have been exposed to a massive dose of substance, Adam. By the time you hear this, I will have armed this facility's defenses on us. You, my friend, must therefore penetrate them and kill me. Please believe that if I could have done it myself... and on that cheery note, you may use the diary lying near this screen to bypass the vocal print locks ahead and enter the security office. The password is Agnes Day.
Here's our next collectible, which is story related.
Agnes Day. This facility belongs to the city now. To Ryan Industries. At least until the rioting subsides. While it is unfortunate that such measures had to be taken, I must admit, it is gratifying to see this building condemned.
Fontaine, I don't know what this is playing again, but I'll be paying the ass.
I am alone at last. Alone with my city.
Please see password to enter.
Agnes Day.
Access granted. Welcome, Gil Alexander.
I heard that. My likeness is company property, Delta, just like you are. Don't make me strip you for parts, Milado!
Well, he's obviously going to be a handful. So this is where we've got to get into.
Voice print lock with that awful crooning. See if you can find some way to sabotage his control of building security.
Delta, you're dawdling. The security office is well above your pay grade. If you're so keen to help, the restrooms need a good scrub. Here's a clerk or two to help you along.
No trouble whatsoever. Right, so here's our next collectible.
Prison, it seems, was a blessing. Ryan is now dead by his own son's hand. But far more interesting is the program of compulsion bred into his child, coded WYK. It was some manner of verbal trigger phrase, which the boy would obey as an order, unerringly. In a way, this sad thing, this half-man, had escaped the self. highly intelligent, but devoid of so-called free will with all its convenient blind spots. What if he had been instructed to uphold the common good? What if he were a volunteer?
Thank you.
shelter. Its value is 10 times your own.
Yeah.